In this video, we're going to cover attachments. Now, if you saw the video prior to this one, kind of pointless because I kind of went all into that one, but let's look at it anyway. Let's go to attachments, company, setup, attachments. Now, Intacct allows you to add PDF documents to journal entries, AP bills, AR invoices, pretty much anything, even dimensions, customers, vendors can have attachments added to them. So let's say we go to AP and we go to add a bill. Here you'll see attachments. You can come in here and you can add a scanned in invoice as attachment so it tracks with the bill. Now, if you have it preloaded, there'll be a list of attachments here. If not, you can add it on the fly. We have our auto numbering system here. You can give it a name. Bill for something. You can choose the folder, which if I thought this out, I would have done that video first, but I didn't. The folders are used for organizing your attachments. Give a description and then browse for the PDF. And then once it says 100% or complete, make sure the progress is 100% or complete. It doesn't happen too often now because the system's so much more faster with advancement technologies. But if it was not at 100% and you click save, most times it's not going to save that attachment and you'll just have an empty file. And when someone goes look, they'll get all upset because I can't find my file. Why isn't it in here? So make sure it's at 100% and then click save. Then once you click save, you'll have your attachment. The name will show here and you can just click the little paperclip. And it'll show the attachment. And see, this is what they'll get if you saved it too soon and hadn't completed uploading. As well as, because I don't have an attachment here. But that'll bring up the PDF or the Excel file or something like that, whatever you put in there. Now, what you can do is you can preload the attachments, which many people do if they have a lot of them, especially say a lot of invoices or bills that you're doing that day, they'll come in and look. Why would they do that? Because, unfortunately, at this time, Intacct does not have a way to mass import attachments for the normal user. There's not a very effective way to do that. Now, if you have a third-party app, such as maybe PaperSave or someone like that, normally you could put their URL on the bill itself, usually as a custom field, and you can click on that and go out to it. But that's kind of a pain because you got to have a third-party system. But they allow for mass import of their attachments. Here, you have to load them one at a time. You have to go add. And like we saw before, you'd have to attach it here. So it's not the best as far as that goes, but it's nice to have everything located in one area in your one system. You don't have it stashed somewhere else. So it's hosted here in the Intacct instance. So that's why the attachments are fun. You just need to be sure that you're aware that you can only load them in one at a time. Well, I take that back. You could, in theory, take all of your bills for a particular check run, maybe, or bill payment day, or bill creation day, scan them all into one giant PDF and import it and attach that same PDF to all of the bills that are related to it. I used to work for a company that did that. The only joy with that was that every time you wanted to find the bill, you had to scan through that big PDF and find that one invoice. Not the most fun, but it solved the problem that they wanted solved. So that's the joys of attachments. Now, in the next video, I will show you, or I will discuss attachment folders and actually create one or two, I think. All right.